ओके, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन. आई एम काजल वर्मा, क्लिनिकल इंस्ट्रक्टर ऑफ मदर टेरेसा कॉलेज ऑफ नर्सिंग, एंड आई एम बैक विथ अनदर मस्कुलोस्केलेटल डिसऑर्डर्स एंड डिसीज. एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज ऑस्टियोमेलाइटिस. एज द नेम सजेस्ट, ऑस्टियोमेलाइटिस इज द इन्फ्लामेशन ऑफ द बोन दैट इज कॉज्ड ड्यू टू इन्फेक्शन ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म और ड्यू टू बैक्टीरिया. सो लेट्स प्रोसीड टू आवर टॉपिक. Osteomyelitis. Nelton called osteomyelitis in 1834. This means Nelton was the scientist who coined the term osteomyelitis first time in 1834. It includes three root words. First is osteon, meaning bone, myelo, meaning marrow, itis, meaning inflammation. So the combination of these three root words comes to be the clinical state in which bone is infected with microorganism, as I said earlier. Now definition. Infection of bone and marrow is known as osteomyelitis. That means infection of the bone with its marrow is known as osteomyelitis. It may remain localized or it spread through the bone to involve the marrow, cortex, periosteum and soft tissue surrounding the bone. Sometimes what happens, if the treatment is taken at right time, osteomyelitis remains localized in the particular area. But if not, if it is ignored, then it may spread to other adjacent areas that are marrow, cortex, periosteum, soft tissue surrounding the bone. And it also causes inflammation of the bone, as itis is there in our term. Now classification. There are basically three classification according to its duration, mechanism and host response. So let's proceed to our classification, that will be duration. Osteomyelitis is divided into three forms as per duration. So according to duration, osteomyelitis is divided into three forms, that is acute, which will be of short term, subacute, little more than the acute osteomyelitis, and chronic, that will be long term. So osteomyelitis will be termed as acute when the infection or symptoms will be seen more than 2 weeks or till 2 weeks. Osteomyelitis will be termed as subacute in duration when the infection is more than 2 weeks but less than 3 months, and it will be termed as chronic if the symptoms proceed till 3 months or more than 4 months, then it will be termed as chronic osteomyelitis. So this was the duration of classification of osteomyelitis. So next classification is according to the mechanism, that how the bone gets infected. So according to that mechanism, this classification is done. Let's proceed to first one. Hematogenous osteomyelitis. Primary hematogenous osteomyelitis is characterized by an acute infection of bone caused by feeding of bacteria within the bone from a remote source. So it is said that primary hematogenous means first line osteomyelitis is caused when the acute infection reaches bone by traveling. Means that bacteria reaches the bone, or acute infection occurs when the bacteria reaches the source due to any medium or due to any source. So that is termed as primary hematogenous. Hematogenous osteomyelitis usually occurs during period of growth and thus occur primary in children. However, all ages may be affected and cases are found in old age. Now this point says that hematogenous osteomyelitis occurs during the period of growth, means when a human is growing or when the bones are growing. So at that time hematogenous osteomyelitis occurs, that means mainly in children, but it affects all type of ages, but mainly it occurs to children because it occurs during the period of growth. Causes of osteomyelitis. General factors are anemia, debility, infection, poor nutrition, poor immune status. Local factors can be metaphyseal hemorrhage, defective phagocytosis, rapid growth at metaphysis and vasospasm. Types of organisms that contribute to osteomyelitis are bacteria, viruses and fungi can all infect bone. soft tissues and joints, as we studied earlier, that it is the infection that is caused by microorganisms. So these are the organisms that are involved. Generally, bacterial infection are more destructive and more rapidly. This point says that bacterial infections are more destructive, that causes more harm and moves rapidly. That means it moves from one place to another place more easily and more rapidly. Fungi tend to produce slow and chronic infections. Fungi also causes infection, but these are slow in their onset and causes chronic infection. Tuberculosis and brucellosis range from aggressive to reparative. Now, clinical features. In early acute phase, clinical features will be febrile illness, limping to walk, avoidance of using the extremities. In late acute stage, swelling and pain will be seen. Subacute, cannot pinpoint onset, fever and swelling will be seen. And in chronic stage, purulent drainage can be seen. That means inflammation will occur in chronic stage and there will be a presence of purulent drainage, or we can also say there will be presence of pus in the affected site or joints. General symptom of osteomyelitis. First one is fever due to infection, fatigue because bone will lose their capacity, irritability, malaise, restriction of movement of limb. We know that restriction of movement of limb will be due to harm to our bones or our joints of extremities or our body. So there will be restriction of movement. Local edema, erythema and tenderness. Risk factor. The factors that contribute to osteomyelitis can be trauma, prosthetic orthopedic devices. Prosthetic or orthopedic devices are useful devices, but if some person is so much keen to use that devices or are very much used to that devices, this can cause osteomyelitis by weakening the point or weakening the bone or body of the person. Third one is diabetes. Fourth one is peripheral vascular disease. Intravenous drug abuse. Intravenous drug abuse will lead to osteomyelitis because intravenous drug abuse can cause our bones to get fribrile or brittle. That will decrease the bone capacity. So it leads to osteomyelitis. Chronic steroid use, immunosuppression, tuberculosis, HIV and AIDS, sickle cell diseases. Sickle cell diseases can also cause osteomyelitis because it is also the infection of our marrow. With bone, it also infects the marrow.